Hi guys, welcome to 2 Minute Tuesdays. I had to change the time to 2:15 because I didn't realize my gardener was going to be here. But anyway, 2 Minute Tuesdays are when I take 2 minutes to show you something that will help you in your daycare business. So I don't want to go past 2 minutes, so I'm going to jump right in. So today I'm talking about how I maintain my files for the children in the daycare. So full disclosure, I am a home daycare, so this may or may not apply to providers who are daycare center based. But for at-home providers, you might find this helpful. And if you do, hopefully you can get something out of this video. So first of all, I just want to start off by saying that I'm going to show you some features. Well, let me just jump in. Anyway, this is my file folder. I pulled an old client file, so I wouldn't divulge any new information on anybody. But this is a multi-section file folder, okay? So I believe it has 6 different sections to it. It is made by, I pulled this up here. It's made by Smead. Now, I got these quite a few years ago, so they might have a different model number, and I'll leave a link at the bottom of this video to kind of show you or to give you any information on what it's called now. But anyway, so I just want to show you how I lay this out, because this system has actually helped me get not only keep my files up to date, but it's also helped me get through my annual visits with licensing quicker. And I'll explain that in a moment. But anyway, so I just want to start off by saying, this is how I lay out my files, okay, for the children. So the first section of this folder I reserve for emergency info. So this is a printout that is generated by my software that I use for the daycare. But if you didn't have that, or if I didn't have that, I would probably put the first thing in the file, and it's easily accessible. I do keep their information, their emergency information, in other places. But in the file, I keep it as the first thing in the file. Okay. So the next section is for licensing paperwork. And I just said a moment ago how this system helps me get through my licensing visits faster. And this is why. This is the main reason why. Because right here in this next section of the folder is where I keep all of the licensing forms. So I've made a cheat sheet or checkoff list here for myself for all of the licensing forms that need to be in this file that licensing or my LPA will probably be looking for me to have updated. So I made a checklist for myself so that I can make sure that all the forms are there. And I actually date it to make sure I can remind myself when was the last time I looked at this file and make sure that the forms were up to date. Okay. So in this section is where all of the licensing forms go. So typically when my analyst comes out, they don't go past this. It's all the forms that they need to see are right here up front in the folder, and that's it. Okay. So the next section is actually for me or for my program. So it is paperwork that is specific to my daycare program. So here in this section, you would find my contract. Right here on top is the get acquainted form. So I typically have them fill out, parents fill that out so that we can get to know the child, more specifics about the child when they first enroll. So I keep that on top, but you would also find a photo waiver, here beneath. So this is the information that is specific to my program and my program only. Okay. So that's where I keep that information. The next section here, it's labeled reports. You can see that I don't have anything here. I believe in the beginning I was keeping copies of their daily reports here, but we use an app for it, so I don't print them out. But you could use this section for something different, just to keep that information there, whatever you decide. All right, now the next section is for payments. Again, I don't have anything here, but what you would find here is perhaps the payment agreement, If there was an NSF or a check that was returned, maybe I would keep that information here or a note stating that. Or let's say the parent wanted to change the way that they submitted their tuition payment, I would have that information here, okay? And in this last section, it's labeled notes. And this is where I keep any correspondence I have with the parent. So if it's email, or anything that went back and forth between me and the parent, I would keep in this section here, okay? There's also, you know, of course, the notes section underneath. You can keep any post-it notes or something there as well. So this I don't want to go over 2 minutes, but this file system has really helped me. And I know you might be thinking, yes, these are probably cost a little bit more than the standard manila folders. And yes, they do. But you only have to make that investment one time, right? So if you have however many children are your license is licensed for or approved for, you can buy that many folders, and then you only have to do that one time because you can recycle them. Just like I blocked this off here. I blocked it off because I was going on a video, but I just put another label over and switch it out. When a child leaves the program, I can reuse that folder. These are pretty sturdy. They're not as flimsy as the manila folders, so they're more of a board-like. So they last. This set has lasted me for years and years and years. So anyway, that's what I've got for 2 Minute Tuesday this week. I just wanted to show you how you can manage your children's files maybe a little easier, make it easier on you, not only to keep up with the files, but also if licensing comes out, most of us know that they want to look at our children's files. Okay? All right, guys, I'll see you next week.